You're watching Sitka Community TV. Be sure to like and subscribe if you like what you see.
Ancestral homelands of the Tlingit people who have lived in Sitka since time immemorial. We express our deepest respect and gratitude for our indigenous neighbors and friends, the Tlingit, for their enduring care and protection of Tlingit Ani. Hi, I'm Ellie. So I am the AmeriCorps at Pacific High School, and today I will be serving as your mistress of ceremonies. I've been here for a couple of years now, and as a single woman who recently moved to a small town from an urban area, I have to say the Hallmark movies get it wrong. No one has taught me the true meaning of Christmas. Yeah. But I am incredibly grateful for the community that I have found both at Pacific High School and in Sitka. I am also incredibly grateful for, you know, the opportunity to get to know these amazing students in their last few years of high school. All right, our first speaker is an individual who is relentless in her advocacy and support for students, restorative justice practices, and the hands-on and creative learning opportunities that make Pacific High School unique. Her passion for furthering opportunities for students to enhance their skills in ways that positively impact their futures has resulted in a massive expansion in the gardening and food security program at Pacific High. She is a kind, encouraging person who has facilitated the projects and contributions to the school about which I am passionate, something for which I am extremely grateful. Without further ado, I give you our principal, Mandy Summer.
Celebrate with us and our graduates. And I want to say a special thanks to Ellie. As she mentioned, she's been here for 2 years. It's not often that as a community organization we get lucky enough to have an AmeriCorps stick around for another year with us. And Ellie has done just that, and we couldn't be more pleased at Pacific High School. She just became a part of the family so quickly, and I was overjoyed when she decided to stay on another year and stick with us at Pacific High as our academic support AmeriCorps. So just a big round of applause for Ellie, because she's put in the over here, because much of this is for the graduates. But this is a tremendous milestone for for each of them, as you all know. All have made it to this point amidst a sea of obstacles that life has thrown their way. And yet, these students have persevered and overcome to make it to the stage today. Gosh, I'm also realizing the first year I did this, I didn't need glasses, and now I feel like I kind of need glasses, which I forget to bring with me. Each of the graduates have proven to themselves and others that they have the power within to beat the odds by reaching the summit of this mountain that we call high school. Each having a refined set of tools in their pack that they're ready to use. They are ready to embark on a new adventure, more confident and more prepared. They're ready to leave their mark on this world and begin to carve out their own unique legacy, wherever that path may lead. The graduates who have made it here to the stage tonight are turning a corner. What lies ahead might be somewhat uncertain, but there is no limit to the amount of growth that each will achieve, and no doubt that they will all leave a lasting legacy wherever they go. So to our graduates, their families, the Pacific High staff, the Sitka School Board, all of you who are here today, and to all of those who have come before us here in this special place, a heartfelt thank you, Ganeshchish, for the role you have played in making this moment possible. Thank you.
Our next speaker with a message to the graduates has been a friend of Pacific High for over a decade. He was a tutor at Pacific High School in 2009 while working for the Sitka Native Education Program. He's been a longtime vocal advocate for Pacific High School, our students, their families, and their extended families. This fall, he joined a government class with social studies teacher Matt Groen that took juniors and seniors on a learning journey through state, local, and tribal government. He is a current school board member, former city assembly member, skilled writer, masterful orator, dedicated Sitkin, and longtime Pacific High School friend. We are grateful to have Tristan Gavon here tonight, offering up his message to the graduates.
All right, well, graduates, family and friends, I feel like I finally made it here in Sitka. Phil knows what I'm saying, you know. I've been waiting a long time to be a speaker at the Pacific High School graduation, so thank you, graduates, for giving me this opportunity. Anyakusani, Gnoschish Hatyadi, honorable people, thank you for being here today. And thank you for allowing me to speak at this, the 2023 Pacific High School graduation. First, let us acknowledge the graduates sitting here today. Today is the culmination of their kindergarten through 12th grade education, and all the hard work and dedication they have put into getting to this point. Let me also acknowledge the family and friends sitting in the audience, Pacific High School staff and community. You have supported them in getting to this point. As Ellie so nicely introduced me, my name is Tristan Gavon, and I'm a member of the Sitka School Board. I'm a longtime manager and director for Sitka Tribe of Alaska Education Programs. And as Ellie said, I had the opportunity this past fall to teach a government class with social study teacher Matt Groen. And that was really a privilege. A number of the students here were in my class, and I got an opportunity to know them and really know the school in a way I hadn't had the opportunity previously. You know, and as far as the hats that I wear, that I get the privilege to wear, I think like you, one of the ones I value most is being part of the Pacific High School community and family. When I started at Pacific High back in 2008, I came into an amazing school with amazing students. I've got to know the school over the years. I've got to know crew, the time in the morning when you get together, your family inside the family at Pacific High School. The thing that shows that Pacific High School sees you all as whole people and not just numbers. Block classes that allow students to explore their interests, to take those deep dives into the things that they're passionate about. Project and place-based learning. Topics that are relevant, local, that connect students to the community and vice versa. Service learning, giving them the opportunity to give back, to engage in civics, and to do things that they'll do in their futures. And Friday life skills, the connection, the way that Pacific High shows that it values community and wants to bring it into its school. The opportunity for students to explore passions, interests that maybe aren't taught Monday through Thursday. Pacific High, this is how school should be. This is how learning should be. This is how community should be. And now, since this is a Pacific High graduation, I'd like to give some kudos. I'll keep going on about Pacific High for a little bit, give some kudos to the staff, but really, to the graduates and students. So first and foremost, Pacific High is student-centered. It's allowed you, and it allows all students, to explore their interests, their passions, to build their knowledge, skills, and confidence on topics that they care about, in fields that they will pursue in life. And most of all, it sees student experiences, identities, and ideas as strengths that can be leveraged in the service of academic, cultural, and social emotional learning and growth. It takes a holistic approach to student learning, starting with seeing social emotional learning and development as co-equal to content areas like math, English language arts, science. It knows that student wellness is at the center and a precondition for learning. It incorporates Tlingit and Alaska Native cultures, or Tlingit Kusti'i, into classes in the school environment in a meaningful way. And it takes a fully culturally responsive approach and incorporates the identities, the cultures of all of its students into learning. And again, it is community-based and community-connected. Beyond Friday Life Skills, it is committed to bringing community into schools and school and students into the community. And now some kudos for staff. And I really can't say enough about staff, both past and present. They make the school what it is, and they make all these opportunities possible for their students, for families, and for community. They go above and beyond. They teach, you know, the principals teach cooking classes or become the cook. They are in the schools on Sundays planning their lessons for the week. They're creating learning and expeditionary activities that tie to students' passions, excitements, and that encourage them to learn and dig in. So again, I just can't say enough about the staff, the administrators, the teachers, the counselors, the support staff. Gnathish, I appreciate everything that you all do. And of course, we are here for the graduates, for the students, and so let's give some kudos to the students. Yeah. Applause lines in here, but you know my monotone makes it hard to pick up. So I apologize to you in the audience. So one of the secrets to good teaching is letting the students do the work. And what I'm going to say in this next session really comes from the students themselves. It comes from some of our discussions in the class that Matt and I took. It comes from input and ideas from the students in all school meetings. These are the student voices. Who are Pacific High students? Who are these graduates? They are caring, empathetic, funny, observant, adventurous, creative, kind, talkative, eccentric. They are short and tall, energetic, shy, stubborn, obsessive, patient, persistent, loud, and of course, silly. I'll give you some practice. And why did they come to Pacific High, and what do they like about Pacific High? They value the social-emotional support. Pacific High is friendly. Like them, it is creative and allows them to be creative. They may not have been happy at other schools. They have family who are alumni. They're not just a number at Pacific High School. They love the Pacific High environment, what one student described as good vibes. They value the Pacific High community, and Pacific High cares about your well-being. And how do these graduates and the students of Pacific High want their school and their world to be? They want it to be unified. Again, they want it to be silly. Respectful, honest, accepting, loud and quiet, perfectly whelming, not too overwhelming, but just perfectly whelming, perfectly unperfect, authentic, prepared, progressive, creative, unique, inclusive, humorous, welcoming, and supportive. But again, we're here for the graduates. So let's give them another round of applause. These graduates, you all embody these characteristics. On stage, we have artists, writers, scientists, musicians, apprentices, and future journeymen. Pragmatists, dreamers, social workers, our peers, and community leaders. And if Silas keeps working on his 360 flip, maybe a professional skateboarder. I'm not really up here to give you too much advice. After all of us adults in this room are still trying to figure it out. Right, that dirty little secret that you probably all know by now. This is what my advice would be. Be what Pacific High School is and what you contributed to Pacific High School. Be your authentic, caring, adventurous, kind, creative, and persistent selves. And above all, remember to give yourself up and others love and kindness as you go out into the world. Our 2023 Pacific High School graduates.
All right, next up we have the presentation of the UA scholarship by Dr. Paul Kraft. Dr. Kraft has been the UAS campus director for 3 years and has a background in sociology, counseling, and adult higher education. He earned his master's degree at Northern State University in South Dakota and his doctorate in education in Montana. Before his current position at UAS, he directed programs at colleges in Oregon, New Mexico, and Colorado. Dr. Kraft holds a special place in his heart for alternative schools, and we hope he shares that story with you tonight. Please welcome Dr. Paul Kraft.
Good Thank you. It's good to be here. Pleasure to follow my friend Tristan Gabon. One of the things that he didn't mention with Tristan is he's also the chair of the Campus Advisory Council for the University of Alaska Southeast Sitka campus. So I have the pleasure of working with Tristan on a regular basis as he brings his knowledge and expertise to make us a better university here for Sitka. I come to a lot of commencements, a lot of graduations, both colleges and universities, but I will say that this graduation for Pacific High School always stands out in my mind. There's something unique about it. It was referenced that I have a unique place in my heart for alternative school, and that is absolutely true. My daughter graduated from an alternative school. My daughter became pregnant when she was 16, had a baby when she was 17, and graduated. If it wouldn't have been for the alternative school in Bozeman, Montana, I doubt she would have graduated. And so as a parent, that was tremendously encouraging and just rewarding to see her. Now, this is crazy, the irony of this. So today is my birthday. Only thing I said, So while I was sitting back there, my phone rang twice. One of it was my mother-in-law, probably to say happy birthday, son-in-law, favorite son-in-law, I'm sure. And the other was my daughter, who I just referenced, who is running home health care in the Denver area, makes more money than I do, and works at least as hard as I do because she also has four kids and is a single mom. So anyway, special place in my heart for Pacific High School and schools like it. So let's go forward, and because there's a lot of people that are going to talk after I'm done. So I want to talk a little bit about the UA Scholars, what we call the UA Scholars. It's the UA Scholar Award is a $12,000 scholarship awarded to Alaska high school students who are in the top 10% of their class at the end of their junior year. The award may be used at any University of Alaska campus and is distributed in the amount of $1,500 per semester. So if the student goes one semester, it's $1,500. If they go all eight semesters, then it's a total is $12,000. It can be used for tuition, fees, room, board, books, supplies, anything that is considered educational cost. The award winner for Pacific High School for this year, the UA Scholars Award winner, is Gabriel McClellan. I just met Gabriel just a few minutes before the ceremony started, so I know very, very little about him, but the things that, to come and stand by me. But some statements were made, were written by members of the staff to, because I asked him, are there some things that we can, that I can say about him, and here's what was sent to me. Gabriel has been laser focused on graduating high school since his first day at Pacific High as a freshman. He is well-spoken, articulate in conversation, and curious and inquisitive in his classes. PHS staff has watched Gabriel grow and mature into a young adult over the past 4 years. And from I found this very impressive. From January to May this year, Gabriel traveled to Valdez to participate in the Prince William Sound Middle College program through UAA and has completed an occupational endorsement in construction skills, which he can use to obtain an Alaska handyman license. So he's already begun his college career. And after graduation, Gabriel plans to use his UA scholarship to return to Valdez and continue his school at Prince William Sound College. And should he continue to, once he's achieved that award, wants to continue with an associate or a bachelor's, that scholarship awaits him as well. So congratulations, Gabriel, for the job. Hand this to him if anybody wants to take his picture.
Next, we have the American Legion School Medal Award. The American Legion School Award Medal Program is designed to emphasize the development of courage, honor, leadership, patriotism, scholarship, and service, and help develop ideals of Americanism among young people, making them citizens of the highest caliber. Here to present the American Legion School Award Medal, please welcome Commander Vince Winter and Vice Commanders Troy Wingard and William Glenzer of American Legion Post 13 in Sitka.
This is my third graduation this week, and I just wanted to call attention to the other two high schools. We have a total of five going on to the military from the graduation point, and we want to wish to thank them for volunteering to serve their country. Their bravery, sacrifice, and strength will not go unnoticed, as we will always be indebted to them and their families for defending our country. So good afternoon, parents, alumni, faculty, and students. My name is Vince Winter. I am the commander of the Henry Gene Burton Senior Memorial American Legion Post 13 right downtown. I am honored to be joining you with you today. And today I have my first vice, Troy Wingard, with us. To start off to the senior class, congratulations. And the best advice I have to pass on to you is a quote from John D. Rockefeller Jr., and I'm old and I live by this one, so this is pretty good. The secret of success is to do the common things uncommonly well. Can't get any easier than that. Today's recipient of the American Legion School Medal Award did just that. The recipient set high standards in her community. Her accomplishments speak volumes as to why she's among the chosen few. This year, only five of these awards were issued in Sitka. Youth are often awarded for their scholastic achievements, but the American Legion believes they should be also praised when they demonstrate strong qualities of character and good citizenship. That is why since 1926, the Legion has recognized such students with the School Medal Award Program. The award is given to young leaders in graduating classes, high schools throughout the nation, and even once in a while, to those who go above and beyond. This year, we actually gave it to a fifth grade class. Candidates for the awards are voted upon by the school's faculty and based on their observations of the candidate throughout the year. The school medal is the highest honor the American Legion gives to American youth. It is a medal that proclaims to the world that you are the kindest student that we, the comrades of men and women who gave their lives in battle, believe worthy of such an honor. It is our desire to wherever you go, and whatever you do, you will always be guided by our highest ideas. So without further ado, it's with great pride that we present this year's recipient for the School Medal Award to Hannah Moser.
Checks. This will be by Chukan, Lucretia Brady, and Kasjak, Clara O'Halloran. Chukan and Kasjak LaCrisha and Claire have been teaching beading classes on Friday afternoons to Pacific High School students for the past few years. Their class is one of the most popular classes offered to students, and it's not uncommon to see students staying after class to continue working on their projects. LaCrisha and Claire have been mentors and teachers, friends and aunties to many Pacific High School students over the years. Thank you both for being here to present the STA congratulatory checks to this year's graduates.
Yagi, Chukani Het du Asak, Akna Hetsati, Chukani Di Ayahet, Kiksadi Adi Hetsati. As Ellie mentioned, my Tlingit name is Chukan, my English name is Nkrisha, and I have the honor to be here this afternoon to present some checks alongside Kosh Chak, who I will let introduce herself.
Hi, Kajak Yuchet du Asak, Takhuedi Ayahet. My English name is Claire, and or Dom's mom. And and I am Takhuedi and a child of the Kiksadi.
For the last few years, Sitka Tribe of Alaska has had the ability to offer checks to tribal citizens who are enrolled with the tribe and graduating, and this year we continue that with three tribal citizen graduates. So this afternoon we have checks for Clover, Gabe, and Alexandra. Instructor Mark Sixby, who has been teaching Northwest Coast Art at UAS for a few years now under Sitka Tribe of Alaska. The certificate states Clover Snelling is recognized for outstanding work in Art 181 and Art 281 dual credit at the University of Alaska Southeast Sitka campus during the 2022-2023 academic year. I want to also acknowledge that Clover has taken many classes, not just this year. If you guys were here last year, they also were able to present two retirees with a drum and a paddle. I have no doubt that this is not going to be the last time you hear the name Clover in Sitka because of their artwork. So congratulations, Clover.
Senior representative. The class of 2023 senior representative was one of the first students I met when I began my service at Pacific High School. Over the last 2 years, it has been a privilege to get to know them, to see their incredible art, and witness their passion for their culture. Clover, the school will undoubtedly be a different place without your presence, but we are so excited for your future and grateful to have been a part of your high school experience. Friends, humans, eavesdropping corvids, I give you Clover Snelling.
After all 12 years of school, we are off to discover what the rest of our lives will reveal. All of us here will be handed the ultimate kudo, confirming our effort and time spent in this amazing school. At the moment, I hold some conflicting emotions. On one hand, I'm excited to see what the future will hold. But on the other hand, I'm also realizing that I will never experience being a Pacific High student again, and that we all have to figure out what steps to take next, which can be both scary and overwhelming. But as we move forward from this massive accomplishment, I hope that we can all look back on the amazing things that we have experienced here. We have made lifelong friends, learned valuable skills, created playlists that will give you whiplash, and grown in ways we never thought possible. I really tried to write this in the most non-cheesy way possible, but that will be especially destroyed by my next statement. Woohoo, class of 2023! Let's celebrate all the events and twists and turns that have brought us to this moment, and let's look forward to all the things we will achieve in the years to come. Congrats, everyone.
All right, it is now time for our family responses. So, family responses are one of the pieces that make Pacific High School graduation so special. At this time, we would like to welcome to stage a representative from each graduate's family to answer the prompt. What is something you are proud of about your graduate, and what is something you wish for your graduate in the future? Beginning with a representative from Gabe's family.
Several years ago, I became his legal guardian and helped him understand the future he can look forward to. I've got to say that his determination, his drive to his drive to be a better person is really shown through the years, and the fact that he's going to go on to back to Valdez to learn more at college it's been a proud emotional moment for me to learn. So I gotta say, Gabe, I love you, I'm proud of you, and I look forward to the man that you will become.
And now a representative from Hannah's family.
Choice, and it's the opportunity to choose whether you're going to go forward or whether you're going to not do the scary thing and stay where you are. And she has had plenty of opportunities to show courage in adversity. And she has displayed courage and she has displayed it valiantly. What I hope for in her life to come is to be there for each moment of your life that will no doubt bring much joy and much adversity. Life is full of adversity. It's full of joy too. I'm not trying to be a downer here. I'm trying to be realistic. And after five kids and living a few years, there's many adversities in life. And there's great joy. But I know that when adversity comes, you will have the courage to go forward and make it through. And I look forward to watching it and being a part of it. And we love you very much.
I should also mention, we recognize that it can often be difficult to stand and speak in front of people. So if the representatives would like to bring other members of, you know, the family or friends to the stage with them, they are welcome to do so. All right, next can we have a representative from Alexandra's family?
Yeah. height adjustment. That was very helpful. So I was told, one, not to cry.
That's impossible,
because I cry every time I'm happy and proud, and not to babble, and I can't promise either one. So the question I was thinking, my greatest desire for my daughter is to always, always feel loved and wanted and held. And she has all this family to do this. Could say I'm the mom and I can take all this credit, but the truth is I really can't. Like, I have so much help and so many people around, and Raven does, that just love her. We have grandparents. We have the man who gave her to me, you know? He couldn't have had her without people allowing me to step in and be mom. And Raven is adopted, so I just have this extra privilege to get to choose my child. So I'm picturing just this beautiful little round face and big eyes just staring up at me, not even knowing that I was going, oh, yes, yep, I'm meeting my child for the first time, but she didn't really know. Second I saw her, I met her. And my most thankful, I'm the most thankful for Raven that she has allowed me to be her mother. That she is so smart and so powerful that she grows. Like, she grows and she changes in very good ways. And I just see such a spunky, powerful, strong woman. And in some ways, when I look at Raven, I see her as this child I met, but also as this amazing, older, wise woman. And I feel like she's taught me so much. Sometimes I feel younger than my daughter. And I'm really not, you know. But I'm thankful that she's wise, and I think that she will only become more wise.
Yeah.
Four, so I have a few more of these to go through. Her sibling, Cody, would like to say something. Oh no, she just wanted to be up here and give her sister a hug. Forgive me.
Representative from Clover's family. Things
weren't always easy for her, and I'm sure you felt down, but the fact that she knows herself so well and is so colorful. Don't laugh at me. She's colorful. You know, she just does so much for what she feels is good for her. And she's had a really good support with this school, and I couldn't have asked for a better school for her to help achieve her goals, because I see her blossoming and just becoming such a beautiful young woman and being so into her culture and being serious about it. And I don't know, we're just proud of her and just happy that she's doing what she feels is best and her own journey. So, thank you.
So
so happy that you stand here. It's hard to believe. We started this journey maybe 2 years ago. And we're from very different places in every possible way, in time, space, and we might as well be from different galaxies. And yet we have been through a lot together. And so the thing I'm most grateful for is that we started the journey, that I met you, that we agreed to do this, that we're staying here right now, and we have this great and really complicated relationship. And I think that's wonderful. And my biggest hope is that this is just the beginning of more to go to that next phase where you're going to discover what you want to do with what you've got now. And so with this, you know, and I'm so hard of hearing with this confidence that this diploma is going to give you. Another hope that I have is that you're just going to speak louder.
Deliver the Uber kudos. I'd like to preface this by saying I love you all. I could have done an Uber Kulu for every one of you. And I'm just so proud of all of you. And watch you guys grow, and you all deserve all of these Uber kudos, and I feel like I could do every single one of yours. However, Matt goes, does somebody feel particularly strong about a student's Uber kudo? And I raise my hand and I say, yes! I have Gabe, okay? With everybody in the eyeballs, Gabe is mine. And I had to preface that because Gabe came here with me. I got to know Gabe and bond over our mutual love of the X-Files back when he was a very young child at Bletchley. And then I got to teach him for many years. And when I moved to Pacific High School from Bletchley, Gabe moved with me. And so I have actually, many of you I've taught different stages. Everyone on the stage I've taught at different times. There were gaps, but for Gabe, it was literally 7 years of Bridget and Gabe. I have watched Gabe grow in a way that I have a privilege to have witnessed. I have watched him just go through some of the most challenging experiences that individuals can ever live and just rise above and have the best words for it. Like, if you don't know Gabe's vocabulary, it's perfect. You're just like, I have no idea where that came from. That's amazing. But I have watched Gabe stay himself and grow and just become this individual who is going to college, earning these endorsements, and just, I couldn't be more proud to give Gabe an Uber kudo for perseverance.
Sometimes at the end of the year at graduation time, when we as a staff organize ourselves around Uber kudos, we have a joke that sometimes we might have to wrestle each other to give a kudo to a kid. And I made it clear to the staff this year that this was my Uber kudo to give, and I was willing to wrestle any of them on staff in order to make sure that I got this Uber kudo. So, I get to present the kudo for Hannah. And I wanted to present for Hannah because we've been doing this a long time. And Hannah and I think the first year that Hannah came, for those of you that know Hannah, I think when or maybe before you really get to know her, she can be very quiet. And for those of you who know me, I'm usually always really loud, and I'm talking like this, and I've had teachers shut their door to their classroom and make eye contact with me because I'm too loud in the office. And so I don't know if I was intimidating to you, but you were a little intimidating to me because I was like, she's so quiet, and I don't know if I'm driving her crazy. No. but I have felt very privileged to be on this journey with Hannah. I feel like your mom took a lot of my words that that I wanted to say. Actually, I didn't have the words. You said them so eloquently. But what your mom spoke about in terms of courage, in terms of fortitude, and your definition of fortitude was amazing. I feel like a lot of our students are on meandering paths, and you know, sometimes Hannah's path meandered and sometimes turned a full circle, kind of did that. But you have risen to this point where you are so confident and you have this like sparkle in your eyes. See, I'm already doing it. I'm like talking in your face. I don't even know if I can put words to it, but to see the growth that you have experienced and just where you're going now and being here on the stage, even though I know that there were times when you were like, it is not gonna happen, and yet here you are. And now you're going out to see the big world, like literally leaving on a plane in 2 days to go on a new adventure. And so I thank you for staying in town long enough to be here for the ceremony. But also, the kudos for perseverance, by the way. You've just done it, and you are like a picture of perseverance for me in my mind, and I just can't wait to see and hear about all of the other adventures that you're going to go on with this courage and fortitude that you definitely have. So.
Accomplishment of graduating. But she embodies honesty especially well.
In every way, from her interactions with peers to the art and poetry she makes, which is amazing, by the way. Raven, the integrity you show in being true to yourself, in advocating for the principles, and beliefs you hold so passionately, has earned you the uber kudo for honesty.
Science teacher here at Pacific High, and I have the honor of talking about Silas. Silas is receiving an uber kudo for honesty. He embodies honesty in a few ways. The first is in how he carries himself. He is very sincere and genuine, and he's just so cool. So those Nike sweats under that? Silas is also honest in how he interacts with his peers. Always tells the truth. And I think most importantly, he's honest with himself, which is sometimes the hardest thing to do. There have been moments this year where Silas has had honest self-reflection, which has led to kicking bad habits and embracing new healthy ones. There you go, Silas.
Hi, everybody. My name is Matt Rowan. I am the social studies teacher at Pacific High School. Randomly, Bridget and Mandy aren't really joking about the wrestling thing. I want you to notice who was first and last in the order, so different information what you thought. But really quickly though, I'm gonna segue over, and this is the one I fought for. Reese, come over here and join me, please. Reese, I'm going to be up front. We chose perseverance for your award, and that word was actually brought up earlier with everybody who has spoken about you. The term perseverance, we've actually heard in multiple contexts tonight. It can be anything to all of us. And Reese, in the short tenure that I've known you over the last 2 years, I have seen him demonstrate this time and time again in a variety of capacities. First of all, Reese is actually a connection to where my family used to live for a number of years. Reese moved here from Western Alaska and hit the ground running immediately. That is a major transition, and to switch schools, to switch communities, to switch overall environment, and he persevered. Life threw Reese a series of obstacles throughout the last 2 years. There were times when you went away, but every time you came back. There were times when even yourself came up. And it's times you would go away, but you came back. And I've been so impressed at his ability to come back, to perform, and not only that, but to hold himself to a standard where he can graduate and cross that finish line. We all have had goals. We have all had timelines for those goals. And I think we can all reflect on times where those do not mesh up. Reese has continually redefined what success is and has worked to accomplish those goals, and that is why we are here today, is because of that effort, because of that perseverance. And I am happy to be this little middle stepping stone in your life as you transition into adulthood, and I can be more proud. So the award for perseverance goes to Reese.
School Board President Blossom Teal Olson.
Why do you sound really official? Bunny Rock. Hello, my name is Blossom Teal Olson.
I am very happy to be here present today on behalf of the Sitka School Board, especially being here to celebrate our graduates. One thing that I wanted to touch base on as an adult looking in and as a parent of a Pacific High student, I want to take some time to express how much Pacific High gathers around their students. And I'm quite envious of that because I'm a graduate of Mount Edgecombe High School. And while I don't want to make the Mount Edgecombe High School gods angry at me, you know, I am always thoroughly impressed and warmed to see the faculty, staff, families, and other mentors at Pacific High gather around their students and lift them up as much as they do. When I was a student, one of the pitch lines that Mount Edgecombe said to us was, the only bad thing is when you graduate, you may never see your classmates again. And I was like, is that really a bad thing? But, again, not to get the high school gods mad at me, I just want to say that in light of how I've noticed and how I've observed how the school cultivates, promotes, allows, permits, creates an overall safe place for their students, I cannot say that any school compares, I think, within the state. And we should be very proud of Pacific High. I just wanted to come here today and just take some time to reflect, because I've served on board 3 years, and when I met Mandy, I was in the back waiting and listening to everyone. I had encountered Mandy, I think, 3 years ago at a budget hearing, about how we should spend or write our budget. And Mandy came up and talked about many different points of why we should not close Pacific High. And I believe after 5 people, maybe more, who got up and spoke to Pacific High and why we should not close its doors, I had to clarify and state, we do not wish to close Pacific High, ever. From my point of view, the service and growth that Pacific High provides is invaluable, and I believe it's a true gem within Sitka. And I will always be an advocate, and I hope, you know, I'm pretty sure the board will continue to hold those feelings. So, again, let's just celebrate Pacific High and its graduates today. You have definitely deserved this day. I hope you guys take your time. Don't let it go by too quickly. If you find that it is going by too quickly, don't be afraid to take a breath. Allow your parents and loved ones to soak it in, even if they are cheesy about it. This is their time as well. Hug, cry, celebrate, be fearful, because life is kind of scary. I'm 40-something, and I'm still scared about life. Just know that you're not alone, and you'll definitely have people looking out for you. You'll have former teachers, former administrators, and overall Sitka looking out for each step that you take after today. So continue to be who you are, Don't let life try and change your viewpoints or your heart. Try to keep soft while also staying strong and fierce. So enjoy your day. Thank you very much for having the Sitka School Board be a part of this graduation.
And now, the moment you've all been waiting for, the conferring of the diplomas. Mandy Summer, back.
You guys ready?
Oh, I need to bring the school board back up for this one. Superintendent Hauser regrets that he's not able to be here. He is out of town, but he would be up here with us, and I am certain that he is incredibly proud of all of you here. And if he finds you in the community, he would be happy to shake your hands and give you a hug and tell you how proud he is of you. So let's go ahead and confer some diplomas. Our first 2023 graduate, Frederick Gabriel Loring McClelland. This is the fun part. Just got back into town on Thursday night, and Hannah works full time, so they weren't here when we did our rehearsal, so we're rehearsing right now, but it's just really good. Hannah M. Mosier. I still can't get the handshake and the handoff, and I still want to hug and stuff, so it's okay. Alexandra Lee Gray Young. Raven Sophia Richards. Joaquin Ocean Rio. Yeah.
Reese James Lowe. Pacific High, class of 2023.